يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ
إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد في سورة الانفطار أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا السماء انفطرت وإذا الكواكب انتثرت وإذا البحار فجرت وإذا القبور بعثرت علمت نفس ما قدمت وأخرت يا أيها الإنسان يا أيها الإنسان ما غرك بربك الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم We begin with the praise that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we ask His assistance and we beg for our forgiveness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace, mercy and blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon His beloved family members, upon His beloved companions and upon all of us and our family members. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. I also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us understand this very important khutbah and put muhabbah, put love in our hearts for what we have to actually love, inshaAllah. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, when we love certain things and when we make it our priority, we go beyond all limits to achieve it or rather to be pleased with it, whether good or whether bad. When we love certain things, we cross all limits for it. And as Muslims, we have two choices. Number one is to love Allah and His Rasul or to love this dunya. And unfortunately, as Muslims, and I speak to myself first, then I speak to you, all of us have probably forgotten what you and I have to love more. And this is why I have started my khutbah with the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Fitar, Surah number 82 and number 6, where I said Allah's words, Ya ayyuhal insan, O mankind, Allah is calling out, Insan, man, ma ghurraka bi rabbika al-kareem, what is making you forget, what is making you heedless about the first love of your life, and that is Allah the Noble. The most noble. With that, I introduce the Jumu'ah Khutbah for this afternoon. And that is, brothers and sisters, the topic is, what are we falling in love with? And I've broken my khutbah into four main headings. Number one, what is the value of this dunya? How does Allah look at this dunya? What's the value of this dunya? I only get one hadith for you to understand what Allah and His beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam valued this dunya. It's collected by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, narrated by Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu, a very senior Sahaba. He said, we were walking in one of the markets of Medina, and Allah's Rasul was in the center, and we were to the left, to the right, and to the left of him. As we were walking, we saw a dead lamb, a carcass, a goat or a lamb, with short ears, with small ears, a dead lamb. And Allah's Rasul went to it, picked it up with its ears, and said, who would buy this for one dirham? Who would buy this for one dirham? They smiled, the Sahaba smiled and said, Ya Rasulullah, nobody of us would buy it less than that. Nobody would even pay a dirham for it. Meaning the price of this dead lamb was less than one dirham in the eyes of the Sahabas. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, it has two things, two problems. Number one, it's dead. Has no life, it's dead. Number two, it's got a defect. Even if it was alive, it has a defect. It's worthless. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiled and said, by Allah, he says, by Allah, this dunya is more insignificant in the eyes of Allah than the dead carcass to all of you. Subhanallah. So what are we falling in love with, brothers? Simple, a dead carcass. That's it. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran about this? About this dunya? I get four ayats, four different ayats from the Quran. Number one in Surah Hadid, Surah number 57 and ayah number 20. Allah mentions, he says, wa'alam, know that this dunya is play and amusement. It's nothing but play and amusement for a limited time. But in that, Allah mentions something phenomenal. It's something that you and I, Allah says, it's a place that you and I will boast for two things. One, mutual rivalry in respect of wealth, which you and I are seeing today. And second, mutual rivalry in respect of children. Allah mentions in the Quran, in Surah Hadid, that this life is nothing but an amusement and play and mutual rivalry in boasting for the wealth and children. And then Allah mentions the same ayat, that this life, it's like to the farmer, it's like a piece of land. When rain comes, its vegetation comes out and he is pleased. He is pleased with what is growing on the piece of land. But when rain does not fall, and there is absolutely no water, it dries up. And you know, sometimes you've seen those lands with huge cracks in between. It's barren, you can't do anything. Allah says the land is like that. This dunya is like that. It only pleases to its tiller, to its farmer, when the produce is there. That's it. So meaning, it's attractive as long as we are living. It's made attractive. And I'll prove it to you in the second khutbah, inshallah. The second point about this dunya Allah mentions is Surah Ar-Rahman. Surah 55 and ayah number 26. If you and I are in a deception that this we are going to live forever, Allah mentions, Kullu man alayha fan. Every single thing is going to be destroyed. So much so that a hadith that everything that on the day of judgment will be made is new. Everything that is made is new. Everything is going to be destroyed. So what are we falling in love with? Something that is going to perish. While we know that this dunya will perish, yet we choose this dunya above that is going to something that is going to last forever. As Allah mentions in Surah Ad-Duha, Surah number 93 and ayah number 6. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْعُولَى. Ayah number 4. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْعُولَى. Surely, surely, the hereafter is more pleasing and never ending when compared to this life. More lasting and more pleasing when compared to this life. And one of the most fascinating verses to show what this dunya is Surah Al-Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in ayah number 185 of the surah, كُلُّ نَفْثٍ زَائِكَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul shall taste death. And the word za'ika means to have the flavor of it, subhanAllah. When you go to a wedding or a good dinner, you say the food, that the flavor was amazing for this whatever the dish was. The meaning of that flavor is za'ika. Allah says, كُلُّ نَفْثٍ ذَائِك, that you will taste the flavor of death. And then, Allah mentioned in this ayat, and then you will be paid on the day of judgment your wages, what you earned for, what you worked for. And whoever is saved from the fire and admitted into Jannah, for surely he has achieved success. And know that this life is only a life that deceives you. SubhanAllah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran has mentioned explicitly, openly mentioning how this dunya is for us. Sometimes I fail to understand so many brothers, when you guys buy a cigarette packet, you know you have a lung and you know it's cancerous, yet we take the cigarette and we smoke. This is exactly what you and I are doing to the Quran. The Quran's cover is showing death ahead for life, yet we choose it, subhanAllah. And we call ourselves educated. Allahu Akbar. The third heading is Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa barik wa sallam. Is what are we falling in love with? Number one. Go back to the hadith that I started my talk. What is this dunya compared to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasul? It's a dead carcass. We are falling in love with a dead carcass when compared to the life that is in Jannah. SubhanAllah. And Allah's Messenger hated people who ran behind money and wealth. So much so that a man like Rasulullah, if you only happen to read his seerah, he was a man to never curse. He would never curse for small things, but he cursed for this. He said, destroyed, cursed, wretched be the person who is a slave of dinars. Cursed, wretched, destroyed be the person who is a slave of dirhams. Cursed and destroyed be the person who is a slave of silk. Cursed and destroyed be the person who is a slave of velvet. For surely, when he is given all these, he is pleased. But when he is not, lo and behold, he is displeased. SubhanAllah. Allah's Rasul says, and how true your heart and my heart, our understanding actually knows. When we want certain things from Allah, when he gives us, be it a car, be it a house, be it anything, a job, whatever, we are happy with it. SubhanAllah. But the same thing when it's taken away, Allahu Akbar, we are sad, we are depressed, we don't know how to handle financial losses. We go into the state of depression. We are on antidepressants for weeks, months, Allahu Akbar. When we have the biggest antidepressant as the Quran. And this is what Allah's Messenger, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you choose this or what you really have to love, then see what Allah says in the Quran in Surah Tawbah, Surah number 9 and ayah 24. One of the strongest verses in the entire Quran is this, brothers. One of the strongest verses for Muslims is this verse of Surah Tawbah, Surah number 9, ayah number 24. Allah says, Qul, say, O Prophet Muhammad, to your people, to your nation, to your ummah, if you love the wealth that you possess, number one, if you love the commerce, your businesses that you fear a decline, number two, if you love the homes that you delight and stay in more than Allah and His Rasul, then wait for Allah's decision to fall upon you. SubhanAllah. This is scary, brothers. You know why? You know who's our opponent? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is scary. Allah is our opponent. Allah is challenging us. If you love these things more than Allah and His Rasul, then wait and watch what will happen. This is why Allah's Messenger says, and I say this hadith and I'll end my first khutbah. And I want everybody to pay attention to this beautiful hadith, subhanAllah. Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every single morning, a person starts his day by selling or destroying his soul. A person starts his day by selling, by freeing, or by destroying his soul. I'll put it in other words, the hadith is, Allah's Messenger says, every morning a person is a vendor of his soul. Either he frees it or he destroys it. But the choice that he makes is whether he loves Allah or this dunya more. Ask yourselves where you and I stand, brothers. Ask yourselves where you and I stand. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فأستغفره إنه غفور رحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم زينا للناس حب الشهوات من النساء والبنين والقناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة والخيل المسومة والعنام والحرث ذلك متاع الحياة الدنيا والله عنده حسن المآب. I begin with the praises that belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I praise Him. We praise Him. We ask His assistance. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and mercy and blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon His beloved family members, upon His beloved companions, and upon all of us and our family members. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. I come to the fourth and final heading of my khutbah. Why is this dunya made so attractive? Why does this dunya look so attractive to us? The verse that I opened the khutbah with is the answer to the question. Why does this dunya look attractive? Allah responds in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3 and Ayah number 14. Allah says, Zuyyina linnas. Zuyyina comes from the word zinah, zinat. Zinat means to beautify something. Zenith means to adorn something. Zenith is when you take a bride and you dress her up in a way that she's really, really pretty and beautiful. That is zenith. You take something and you beautify it. So that's the beholder, so that the person looking is attractive and falls in love with it. Allah says, I have beautified this dunya. Subhanallah. Allah says, Zuyyina linnas. For annas, for mankind. What has he beautified? First, an-nisa, subhanAllah. The most attractive thing for a man is women. No matter which mall you walk in, your eyesight has to scan her. Subhanallah. Allah says, Zuyina linnasi hubbu shahawat. From the shahawat, from the desires that a man, that people have, number one is women. Number two is baneen. Baneen means children. Allah has beautified for us. Allah has made our children. The love of our children blind sometimes. You and I are examples for it. I know, subhanAllah, how I fall into their trap. It's so amazing that a small kid at 4 years can actually divert you from the remembrance of Allah. So Allah says, first, women. Second, baneen. Then Allah says, Qanatir al-Muqantar. Then He says, gold and silver, meaning wealth. Then Allah mentions branded horses. Probably branded horses at that time. Today it's branded cars. Nothing has changed. It's just our perception. Technology changes. Horses just became horsepower. That's it. In our engines. The same horses, branded horses, became horsepower in our engines. And the same horsepower is what drives us crazy. SubhanAllah. And then Allah mentions land, tilth. Today our rental properties, our businesses, our homes, everything Allah has beautified. Subhanallah. And then Allah says, ذَلِكَ مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Everything is for the dunya, use of this dunya. But Allah says, وَاللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ حُسْنُ الْمَعَابِ. But with Allah is something that is unimaginable, is something that is beyond your capacity to think. Why has Allah done this, brothers? Why has this dunya been made so attractive that no matter what we do, we get like magnets, we stick onto this dunya. No matter how strong of iman you have, every morning you might get up for fajr, open the Quran, read the Quran, read these verses, and you think, yes, inshallah, I'm not going to get attracted. One deal where you have to sell your iman, you're ready to do it. One deal where you have to cheat, you're ready to do it. One signature that you have to sign on riba, on interest, you're ready to do it. Subhanallah. It just made you attractive. It just put itself where you sold your iman. Why does Allah make this? He has made it attractive. Allah Himself has mentioned why. So that He may test you and me. Surah Al-Mulk, Surah number 67, ayah number 2. Allah says, Alladhi khalaqa al-mawta wal-hayat. Allah has created death and life, this dunya, hayat. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلٍ. So that He may test each one of your amal and each one of your iman. Subhanallah. Every deed that you and I do is going to be tested. With the attraction of this dunya, how much can you repel yourself with? How much can you actually repel this dunya with your own thing? Brothers and sisters, I'm not asking you to leave your businesses, your homes and sit in a jungle. By Allah, no. I'm only trying to say, make Allah and His Rasul your priority in life. When you love them, Allah will give what you want in this dunya. When you love them the best, Allah will give you what you actually desire in this dunya. Don't shun away from this dunya. Don't turn away from this dunya. What does Allah mention? What do we hajis do every round of tawaf? رَبَّنَا عَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا. First dunya, Ya Allah, make my dunya hasan, excellent. And then my akhirah. But that doesn't mean that you have a dunya that is disobeying Allah and you suddenly get an akhirah that is Jannah. It doesn't match. So brothers, know that you and I are being tested. And when you and I choose this dunya, listen to the words that Allah says. In Surah Yunus, Surah number 10, and ayah number 7, and ayah number 8, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, surely, verily, those who are pleased and happy and satisfied with this dunya, with this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made Jahannam their abode, Jahannam their place. Allahu musta'an. May Allah save us from that. Ameen. In conclusion to my khutbah, brothers and sisters in Islam, I would only like to throw light on iman is to love Allah and His Rasul more. That's it. It's not that you don't have to love this dunya. It's just love them more. That's all. Whatever you are doing today, do it. But just make them your priority. Make them your first love. Make them everything that you have to do. The Sahabas lived their life like that, brothers and sisters. Every single Sahaba is a shining star that when you open his biography, you will say, Subhanallah, this is a man that loved Allah and His Rasul more than anything else. I would like to conclude my khutbah, leaving you with a hadith and a question. The hadith is of Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, that Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, has anyone tasted the sweetness of iman? They said, no. They said, what is the sweetness of iman? Subhanallah. Does iman have a taste? Yes, it has. He says, the sweetness of iman is when you love Allah and His Rasul more than anything else in this dunya. When you love Allah and His Rasul more than anything else in this dunya, that is the sweetness of iman. The Sahabas tasted that sweetness, brothers. The Sahabas tasted that sweetness. The question that I leave you with is, first to myself and then to you. Have you and I, have we tasted the sweetness of Iman? Or are we going to die without even having a taste or smell of our Iman? The choice is what we fall in love with. Subhanallah wa alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa allahu akbar wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. يا الله يا كريم يا غفور يا رحيم يا حي يا قيوم. Today we ask you, Ya Allah, whatever love we have, Ya Allah, for you and the Rasul, increase it, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, whatever love we have for this dunya, Ya Allah, make it second to you and to Rasul, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, whatever love we have, Ya Allah, increase our iman for you and for Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, increase our love for this deen. Increase the love for our sahabas. Increase the love for Allah and His Rasul. Ya Allah, when we stand before you, let us not have a balance that shows our inclinations towards this dunya, Ya Allah. Let us have a balance, Ya Allah, that shows an inclination towards you and Rasul, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, when we stand before you, Ya Allah, hide our sins, Ya Allah. Cover our sins, Ya Allah. Do not hold us accountable before anyone else, Ya Allah. O Allah, forgive our sins. Forgive our punishments, Ya Allah. Release us from Jannah, Ya Allah. Release us from Jahannam, Ya Allah. Admit us into Jannah, Ya Allah. We ask you for the coolness of the grave, Ya Allah, when we are laid into it. We ask you the easiness of the questions that are going to be answered to, Ya Allah, in the grave. Ya Allah, admit us into Jannah. Admit us into Jannah in the company of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the beautiful sahabas. Utlu ma uhiya ilayka min al-kitab wa aqim as-salah. Inna salata tanhani al-fahsha'i wal-munkar wa la dhikrullahi akbar wa aqim as-salah.